Welcome to the Permeability Seminar, done by Fabian Fuentes and Fabian Romero. First of all, what is permeability? Permeability is a porous material property defined as the volume of a fluid of unit viscosity passing through a unit cross-section of the medium in the unit time under the action of a unit pressure gradient. Applications. It has some applications in files as food industry, where it is used for the design of protein packaging. In the pharmaceutical industry, it is used for the prediction of the absorption of oral administration drugs. Moreover, in oil and gas industry, it is used for the optimization of the recovery from the reservoir. Finally, in nanoporous materials such as fabrics, the permeability of air is related to the level of comfort of the material. There are other fields where permeability is as important, such as building and environment science, among others. Two experiments were carried out to perform the use of a permeator. The materials for the experiments were two kitchen spoons, sunrise, two plastic stray bottles, one ruler water, one bottle of 50 milliliters, one funnel, and one Gatorade bottle cap. Procedure. First, the sun was washed and sieved. Afterward, the bottom of the stray plastic bottle and the spoon were cut off, and one piece of the spoon was introduced into each of the bottle, and the normal bottle caps were replaced with Gatorade bottle caps. Then, the solid, rice, and sand were poured into the bottles, one for each bottle, and the top green piece of the sponge was put at the top of the solid. Next step was to put the two heat marks for the water. Finally, the next step was done for each bottle. The bottle was filled with water to the higher mark, and then the time that the water took to hit the lower mark was measured. The volume of the water that fell off was measured in a bottle of 50 milliliters. For rice, the experiment was carried out 5 times because it happened so fast. Results. In the first circle, we have the delta of volume for and the delta and the time for each solid, and then the cross-sectional area of the bottle, the pressure drop, the length of the bottle, and the viscosity of the water were determined and measured. And then from the Darcy equation, the permeability constant was determined. For rice, it was 2.39 at minus 9, and for sand, it was 0.948. Conclusions. The major difference in both systems is the void fraction. For the cylinder that contains the rice, the water flow was very fast in comparison to the flow of the water through the sand. The test of permeability for sand was tried twice, but the velocity of the fluid decreased. The sand reduced its pool density in each round, and consequently, the void fraction is reduced. Third, the test for the rice permeator happened so fast, so it was made 5 times to reduce the error that can be generated by measuring short times. And finally, since the porosity of the sand is lower, the test took more time than with rice. Bibliography. Thanks for all.